It's an issue that's very common, but many women avoid even bringing it up with their doctor. We're talking about pelvic floor issues. Does a sneeze or exercise cause a bladder leak? Is sex painful? Do you have pain lifting or carrying your kids? They're all signs of pelvic floor problems, and no, adult diapers are not the final solution. Physical therapist Mackenzie Barnes with Oklahoma Physical Therapy is here with some better options for us today. Thanks for being here.
Yeah, absolutely.
Let's talk about how common of an issue this is and why women really don't even want to talk to their doctors about it.
Right. So one in five women postpartum actually have a pelvic floor dysfunction, and then about half of women just in general have reported incontinence issues. So it is rampant, and I think that a lot of times women don't like to talk about it because it's either embarrassing or they just think it's normal. And the thing that I tell my clients most is it's common, not normal.
Is this always the result of childbirth?
Not necessarily. So I have clients from 18 to 96, and some of them have had children and some of them have not. So we love to blame the kids, of course, but that's not also like the case every single time.
What else can cause it?
So a lot of times when we strain or exercise wrong or breathing wrong, we can kind of set ourselves up for a little bit more of that issue.
You hear about Kegel exercises, mm-hmm. but sometimes that's not the right way to go.
Right. So oftentimes that will be one of the questions I ask when clients come in is, do you know how to do a Kegel? And they say yes. And then I say, well, actually one in four women don't do a Kegel correctly at all. And then the other couple aren't doing it as coordinated as they need to. And they're like, oh, actually maybe I'm not. So that is one of the first things I address is that coordination and how you do a Kegel correctly.
That's interesting that it can actually make the problem worse by doing that incorrectly, because that's what you hear can fix the problem. But you have other solutions to fix the problem besides Kegels. Tell
Absolutely.
Us about that.
Yes. So oftentimes there are hip exercises, glute exercises, any other thing except for Kegels can typically help strengthen the pelvic floor and your pelvis. But Kegels are not the only thing that we do. So when doctors say they'll probably just have you do a bunch of Kegels when you go. I would say 25% of what we do is Kegels, and a lot of times it's your core, your glutes, your hips, all that, those other things that kind of work with your pelvic floor.
Much more thorough. And mm-hmm. if you don't know how to do a Kegel, we're not going to explain it, but you can Google that.
Yes,
or
definitely.
You can make an appointment with Mackenzie, and she'll be glad to talk you
Absolutely.
Through it.
Absolutely.
So how about working out? We were talking about that. Can that make incontinence worse?
Yeah, so there's a whole lot of moms getting really into CrossFit and boot camps and that sort of thing, and I love it. But there's a great way to go about it, and there's one that's maybe not as safe for their certain condition. So breathing when you work out, making sure that you're not straining or lifting too heavy are great options. And then just really working on your core every time you do a lift or something.
We were talking about straining. You said that also can lead mm-hmm. to incontinence.
Mm-hmm.
Interesting. Okay, so what are some other ways to alleviate it, to make it better, besides just Kegel at
yeah.
work and exercises and so forth? What are some things you can do in your daily life to make incontinence not so severe?
Right. Dietary is one of the biggest things that I try and fix with my clients. So caffeine actually aggravates your bladder a whole lot. So it can make you go like 10 times more than you would normally go, or make that urgency a lot stronger, which can cause some leakage as well.
Interesting. Caffeine. Mm-hmm. Never knew that. Caffeine's supposed to be your friend.
I know, I love it. I can't get rid of it.
Mackenzie Barnes, thank you so much. We appreciate
Absolutely.
You. You can get more information on diagnosing pelvic floor issues and getting treatment at Oklahoma Physical Therapy. They have three locations in the metro.